are the record breakers. Doc Jones, former racing driver, coordinator of a team seeking a new world speed mark for outboards. Hugh Entrop, designer of the boat that will make the assault. Entrop shares responsibility with Jones. Jerry Wallen, driver of the hydroplane that seeks the record. The 27-year-old Wallen is a top-ranked competitor in the Pacific Northwest. This is the approach to the border between Arizona and California, some 175 miles from Phoenix and 300 miles from Los Angeles. The trials will be run on Lake Havasu, a 40-mile stretch along the Colorado River. The lake is formed by Parker Dam, one of a series of concrete barricades that control the flow of the mighty Colorado. Doc Jones tells why the site was chosen.
We like to run in a secluded spot because there is lots of people boating all over the United States today, and we have to have calm water for this type of a boat, this type of a record. It takes a body of water that's approximately 5 miles long so that we have ample deceleration and acceleration room, and we don't want to make people mad, and we'd like to get as far back and out of people's way as we can, and it gives us an opportunity to work without interference.
The boat, Starflight 4, is backed into the pit area. It is a 17-foot hydroplane custom-built by Wilbur McDonald. It was designed for this mission alone, a world record for unlimited class outboards. Writers and race officials are witness to the event. Among them, Mel Crook, Yachting Magazine. Columnist Bill McKeon. Observer Charlie Strang. Engine specialist Jack Leek covers strategy with Entrop. Technician Harold Wade shares his knowledge of the engine with the youthful driver. Wallen's power plant is a basic EVINRUDE 100S. Don Henrich, a specialist on propellers, confers with Wallen before the launch. Wallen, says Jones, was designated driver for several reasons.
Well, Jerry was chosen for more, reasons than one. First of all, he was a driver who had experience at least in boats running in the 80 and 90 mile an hour. He presently holds the B record, the B hydroplane record at 90 miles an hour. Secondly, to hold down frontal area, now I'm speaking of aerodynamics now, we had to put him inside this canopy. The canopy, first of all, either has to be as wide as the engine, certainly, and as wide as the driver. And he's a small boy, and he's about the same width as our motor. So this way we could get a perfect streamlining through this cowling area.
Wallen works the two levers that maneuver the boat. The levers replace the conventional steering wheel. With driver and boat perfectly matched, Jones tells what's needed for world recognition of an outboard record.
You must obtain a sanction through the American Powerboat Association, which is the official sanctioning body for the Union of International Motor Boating. And when this record is completed, if we make this record, it is then submitted to the UIM for approval, and it is then an official world record.
The launch culminates months of intensive preparation. Each member of the crew is assigned a specific task. Debris is cleared from the course to ensure a safe run. The boat is carefully floated from its trailer. Coast Guard patrols block off the course. The boat carries just enough fuel for the test run. The ignition switch mounted on the canopy is checked by the crew. The lightweight driver is carried like a jockey to his mount. Wallen slips into the cockpit. He has anticipated this moment for more than 6 months. He said of the long wait, it was like giving a kid a piece of candy and then telling him he shouldn't eat it. The crew seals Wallen within the narrow confines of an isolated world. From here on, he is strictly on his own. Boat and power plant are ready. Now it's up to the youthful driver to deliver the record. Wallen's first run will be to test equipment. It takes muscle to fire up the engine, As the pit crew works, Jones describes the power plant.
This is basically a stock engine. We're running stock blocks, stock crankshafts, stock rods, stock pistons. We do eliminate all the weight that we can by the elimination of electric start. We do this by hand. We go into the tuned exhaust systems, which gives us additional power and additional torque. To crank this engine, first of all, it's a four-cylinder engine. It's 90 cubic inches, and we don't use a very large flywheel for this type of operation, so you don't have a big cranking diameter, and we have to get some real hefty boys to crank this thing.
As Wallen idles Starflight 4 toward the far end of the course, the boat shows a natural tendency to ride with its bow low in the water. The streamlined 17-footer was designed with weight forward to lessen the risk of becoming airborne at high speeds. For the test run, Wallen will make only one pass over the course. Wallen accelerates Starflight 4 steadily toward test speed. The boat flies smoothly over the water. Everything seems to function properly. Taking no chance on running the boat too close to shore, Wallen stops well out on the water. Entrop is anxious to get Wallen's first-hand reaction to the test run. The boat hit more than 120 miles an hour during the test. Still, Jones claims it was not top speed.
The reason being, it's the first run we've made, and with an engine of this kind, and with a boat of this kind, we like to run this engine rich in the beginning. This saves seizing the engine and endangering the driver in any way. We like to go about this quite cautiously.
Starflight is hauled from the water for minor adjustments after the test. A canopy over the boat offers protection from the sun in 80-degree temperatures. Jones, Leak, and Entrop make a final decision on the assignment of personnel and patrol of the course. They bide time for ideal weather conditions. A midday breeze is expected to abate, permitting a try in late afternoon. There's little action ashore. The Coast Guard remains alert.
Patrol 1, this is Control, over.
Control, this is Patrol 1.
Conditions in your area at this time, over.
Slight drip down swell, a little bit of chop, very little. Looks pretty good now.
Roger on that. Any traffic bothering you down there, over?
Negative. The traffic is all clear on this end.
Roger on that. We're going to try to run this thing here sometime in another hour or so. We got a slight chop here now, and so keep all the traffic calm down there, and that'll just be the wind that gives us any troubles. Over.
The final launch is made. The pit crew works toward its objective, a new world speed record. It's standby for officials of the American Powerboat Association. Inspector Gaston Van Hite, referee Marion Beaver. Chief timer Otto Crocker checks his scanning equipment. Wallen returns to the cockpit. He'll be comparatively comfortable. His helmet is cushioned against a padded headrest. Although there's no room to spare in the tailor-made cockpit, Wallen will have ample air for breathing. Ports for ventilation are spaced along the edge of the windshield. Dedicated teamwork leads Jones to comment on why speed records are not established very often.
Well, if it was easy to do these things, I think high school kids would be doing it every weekend.
Wallen heads toward the course. He will make a straightaway run from north to south, then return in the opposite direction. Starflight 4 starts its run. The straightaway measures 1 kilometer. On plane, the boat shoots down the course. 118, 121, 124. Wallen's run is clocked at 127.10 miles an hour. Wallen accelerates for the trip home. Starflight 4 gains speed and shoots for the mark. 125, 127, 130. Wallen pushes harder. He hits 132. He's going, going. And he's over the line at 134.7 miles an hour, the fastest man has ever gone in an outboard. Crocker certifies the speed. The ball game's over. Wallen has averaged for the two runs 130.929 miles an hour, a new world record. Doc Jones sums it up in human terms.
Now that it's all over, certainly we're happy to a great degree. I don't think this is a crew that would ever be satisfied. They'd be happy with something, but never completely satisfied, because we know there's more in this boat. And certainly in the future, we're going to keep working and working until we go as high as we know how to go. We just don't quit these things. We enjoy it. It's a part of our life.
Jerry Wallen met the challenge. With Starflight 4, he faced the odds. Their performance stands as a clear-cut victory for the men and their boat. These are the record breakers.